14 early school leavers from some of Limerick's toughest neighbourhoods have just 10 weeks to form a competitive tag rugby team to play at an international tournament. Supported by Munster Rugby and Sulis, their journey will also see them tackle a series of educational challenges as they try to overcome past experiences of school. Can a group that the system has failed take on these challenges and learn not to give up on themselves? This is their sporting chance.
My name is Anthony Ryan. I'm 22 years of age.
My name's Kelly McMarlowe. I'm 19.
I'm 19 years of age at the moment. From Limerick, obviously.
I'm living at Morass. It's Byron Road there. All my family's out there.
I live with my mother, my daughter, and my girlfriend and sister.
Family's everything. I don't know, family is just everything. In my eyes, it is anyway.
I like sports. I like art. Love fashion. I'm small.
Sports, I like rugby, soccer, anything I could get dirty with. It was hard a matter of getting dirty if my mother washed the clothes.
Little tomboy. I was growing up. I was out.
Well, I grew up on South Hill. It was kind of all like rob cars and that kind of stuff around. But I used to have to be in at 6 o'clock. I had to be in every hour to check in to make sure that I wasn't out doing gallivanting.
I'm a strong enough girl. Pick it up now. If anyone missed me, they know all about it.
Where I went to school and everything, you learn a lot of that things. You learn how to act, you learn how to behave. And it influences you to be a stronger person, in my personal opinion, a lot stronger.
There's nothing in Limerick. Only chance you get is a job here is working in Dunn's or Tesco. Like,
it's a nice place, but it's not a great place, you get me? Because they're all wrecked on drugs. The whole town is like a bunch of gearheads. This town just needs to be knocked and built again.
Life is tough.
Yeah, but I suppose life is what you make it as well. Do you know, you can't just lie down and give up either.
School wasn't for me. And that was it. It just wasn't for me.
All the studying and stuff, I prefer, like, doing things hands-on.
The way things are nowadays, you need your leave and suffer nearly everything. And I wasn't really the best at reading, like, so that's what kind of let me down.
All tuned in?
Leaving cert, leaving cert, leaving cert. If you don't have a leaving cert, you won't get a chance. And a lot of people won't get the chance to show how good they are.
The first sign of madness is trying to do the same thing and expecting a different result. We need to, you know, think outside the box, really, about how we approach the whole concept of learning, education and training. You know, and that's what CLASP is all about.
We are responsible for every child while they're under our care. So you as coaches have got to start thinking like that when you're doing a demo here.
An initiative of Limerick Southside Limited, CLASP is a community leadership, arts and sports programme which aims to promote employment and development in Limerick Southside. Through the course, trainees develop art and literacy skills while receiving coaching qualifications, encouraging them to take an active role in their community and society as a whole.
It's going to be about passing and changing directions. But we're going to do it with the ball in hands because we want to make it simple for the kids.
With nearly a quarter of Limerick's second level students failing to complete their Leaving Cert, CLASP is a hands-on course that targets young adults for whom school was a negative experience.
Each one of the trainees that are on this particular program have huge amount of talents and skills to offer. The problem is that society hasn't tapped into those skills.
Put away the phones. Focus. Right, so we're moving on to the next module, which is internet skills. All right?
Primarily, our programs are focused on people who have maybe left school early or certainly haven't had the same opportunities in education that others in society might have had.
14, which is gone 15 when I left in fifth year. Like,
I left secondary school in fifth year, So I didn't like it. And then I had a baby.
I was halfway through 6th year when I left school.
I started in 1st year, like in the highest, and my leaving cert in the lowest.
The leaving cert didn't go so good. Failed it completely. Disaster it was.
I didn't do transition year. So when I finished school, I was only 16.
It's a bit young to finish that. No really 16-year-old knows what she wants to do.
When young people or adults are disaffected, you know, there's a lot of reasons for that. You know, I mean, really, Ireland as a country has put its money in academic development and academic achievement. And I suppose really a lot of our programmes that we run are based on, I suppose, giving people a second chance back to education.
All right, see you later, lads.
It was different years ago. You could just drop out of school and get an apprenticeship and just start a job at 15. It's not like years ago. There isn't jobs out there anymore. You need your education now.
It's not quite life and death, but it is last chance saloon, because if you know, if this hasn't worked for people in the past, as in going to the formal settings, the schools and colleges, and we get it wrong, well then where do we go from there?
Basically, you take what comes, you just deal with it. You have to be strong. You have to be tough.
Yeah, I like Limerick. It's my hometown. Home is where the heart is, so Limerick is where my heart is.
A lot of people look down on Limerick. I'm sure a lot of people who will even be watching this, they have their own idea of what Limerick is.
Limerick's a nice place, but there's bad people in it. Like, not bad people, like, there's just ruined people in it.
For people that live in Limerick would realise that the county isn't really as bad as what it's making, they're making it out to be. It's the papers and the news.
It's all, you know, stabbings. It's all the bad, like.
There is good things that's going on around just well, but people just aren't opening their eyes to see it.
That's the way the world is now. It's better to be negative than it is positive.
Limerick's a nice place to visit, like. I won't stay here forever, like, but
I don't know, Limerick is confusing. Don't get me wrong, it's my hometown kind of thing, like, but I'd prefer to live somewhere else. Somewhere would have, like, proper jobs and proper people. I don't know if I'd be able to stay away forever, though. I don't know.
I think it's a very Limerick thing. You never give up. There's a fight in us. You have to be strong through certain situations. You know, pride in yourself is very important.
Sport is big in Limerick, especially rugby, with Thomond Park and Munster winning. It's just great for Limerick.
Whether the win, lose or draw, everyone has respect for the Munster squad. Like, they rightly live up to their saying and stand up and fight.
Nowhere in Limerick is this sense of pride and unity more evident than at the internationally renowned Thomond Park. Home to one of the nation's most celebrated teams, Munster Rugby. The stadium dominates the skyline, and the team is the glue that binds the city. Despite this, few within the group have any interest in or knowledge of rugby, but that is set to change. It's early January, and the trainees have been brought to Thomond, where two legends of Irish rugby are waiting to make a unique proposition, one that will test them completely.
I suppose I would say I have a real love for all sports, and I think that's no accident coming from Limerick. That's very much part of who we are.
Alongside a successful career in the Defence Forces, Liam Toland played rugby for Munster and went on to captain Leinster. Today he is a respected rugby analyst with the Irish Times newspaper.
A club is a group of like-minded people who come together to share in the experience. Sport gives you that enormous opportunity. The camaraderie, the fun, the friendships are huge.
Together with her father, Brendan, and brother, Munster coach, Anthony, Rosie Foley is a true icon of the sport, playing a key role in the rise of women's rugby in the country.
39 times I played with Ireland. I ended up playing rugby to the highest level and emulating my father and my brother, which was a huge dream come true. So I suppose I never, and I still don't, believe that there's nothing you can't achieve.
Okay, folks, our first few steps that we're going to take start here in Thomond Park. What an iconic place for it to begin for us.
There's going to be a number of challenges over the coming 10 weeks. They're going to be both mental and physical. The mental is going to be very, very interesting for you because I'm not so sure how much background you have in it, and that's why it's a challenge. The first part is sports journalism. The second part is photography. And the third part is event management. But underneath all that is the foundation, is the physical side.
And the physical side, guys, is for the next 10 weeks, you're going to have to work hard, you're going to have to get yourselves fit, and you're going to have to get fit as a team. We are representing Limerick, we're representing our community here, and we're going to play in an international tag tournament in London in 10 weeks' time.
And then it's up to you to maybe jump up and grab it. And I think that's the bit that Rosie and myself would like to bring to you, is we have great opportunity in this short journey, and let's see if we can grab it and enjoy it and have fun and be able to look back with a lot of pride in that.
The challenge is set. Over the next 10 weeks, with the help of some well-known faces from Munster Rugby, Liam and Rosie will attempt to share their passion for the game and to get a team ready for an international tag competition. In addition, the group must complete a series of challenges designed to build their skills and broaden their experience.
I would hope that the majority would buy into our project and want to compete and want to learn a little bit more about themselves.
We're not aware of it now, like, because Jutso is kind of far away. But we're like, when it comes to it, like, we don't want to lose, like, because we don't want to go over there and look like complete idiots. Because we want to go over there and show them how actually good we actually all are.
But are the trainees really aware of the hard work that lies ahead? At the University of Limerick, Munster's training ground, the group gathers for their first formal coaching session. The 10-week countdown to the tag rugby competition starts now.
The real carrot, the real gem, is a trip to London. But the tournament itself, it's a massive tournament, it's an international tournament.
You know, give it a go. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
But a key aspect of tag rugby, you have to perform as a team, because if you're not doing one thing, your teammates will be let down. So that's a huge part of it. So we'll start off with the very basic of just simply passing the ball to each other.
When you have the rugby ball in two hands, you can't move, all right? But you pass it to somebody who can move. Ball! That's it! And catch! Yes! Ah, oh, you can't run with the ball! Ah, oh, you can't run with the ball! You can't run with the ball!
Jump and on the pitch,
feet.
You're
He's
off
inside.
The pitch!
He's outside!
And there's the pitch! What are you doing over there?
I don't even know fully for sure what we're getting ourselves into, to be honest, but like the basic rules, like most of the group don't know them.
We start with Audrey here, you want to start, you're just going to take two paces and pass, two paces, pass, here and pass. That's it, lovely.
And
coming forward.
Some of the skills, as I said already, wouldn't be great. You know, some of them are
actually,
coming
one
out
of the girls that would remain nameless can't even run, so that's a skill deficiency.
I think
she's
that's a huge skill deficiency. our aim is to get her running. We're defending in a line. Have a look at somebody and you're going for them. Go now.
They're great coaches. They point out what we're doing wrong in a nice way and show us how to do it correctly and don't go down our throats on it. And I think they're great. I like them.
Go!
Stop.
I was just thinking that we're going to be playing like an Olympic tag rugby team or something, that it'll just be very good and we need to practice more.
As you're running along, don't run ahead of the ball because he can't pass it to you. Because the rule says, the law is you have to pass the ball backwards.
And I think a core ingredient for the whole duration is to have fun. Certainly when you see Irish rugby at its best, or any sport at its best, the players are actually enjoying it.
And the basics are done correctly, you know. So I think we're going to really focus on those basics.
Go on. That's it. Lovely. Now, yes.
You are making me out to be worse.
Some serious characters.
But we've a long way to go.
When are we going to London?
The first steps to the tag tournament in London have been taken, but there are more challenges than sporting ones ahead. Today sees a switch in positions for Liam. In his role as an Irish Times journalist, he's meeting the trainees to introduce the first literacy project.
So today we're going to spend about a half an hour to prepare ourselves
for something quite exciting, actually.
Put simply, it's a project on a Munster sporting hero. 250 words they'll have to write, research it, etc. And they'll also have an opportunity to take a photograph of that Munster hero. And the fruits of their work then will be publicly displayed.
How do you write a pen picture about a hero? What do we even do? So I would call it the five W's, all right? Five W's and a H. Who, what, where, when are objective. No, they're facts. The why and the how are subjective. Bianca, give me somebody we would go to. I don't care who it is. Keith Earls, okay? Who is Keith Earls?
A Munster rugby player, really.
Okay, Munster rugby player. Is that all he is? What else? Irish international, you said? These are all simple things, but we need to know them before we meet him. Okay, is hangman part of the exercise? Is it?
So I haven't done anything like it since we left school, so it's a whole new experience for me. But I'll see how we get on. Might spark something I might be interested in.
Okay, the why, ladies and gentlemen. Why would you pick Keith Earls? What's so interesting about Keith Earls?
He's from Myras, which is a lower speculative area. No one thinks much of it.
And what's so special about that then?
Just goes to show that there's talent in regeneration parts of the town as well.
If you're writing 250 words, what you've just said is really interesting. Yes, we know Keith Earls plays blah, 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 but the bit you've just mentioned is the unique bit to you that will be unique to you to write, and when someone reads it, it will be unique to them to read it.
Maybe in time, the group or someone within the group might get back into some more formal academia, might be asked to write a CV, for example. They might want to write a blog.
So when you're writing it, there's a structure. So you're going who, what, where, when, then you get to the why and the how. Thanks, lads. Thank you. Thank you. You're the best audience I've ever had.
With the group's fitness already a concern, Liam and Rosie have asked the sports science team at UL to conduct a cardio endurance test. But this bleep test will not only gauge the group's fitness, it will also determine their levels of commitment.
My fear is some of the guys have yet to buy into the concept.
The critical thing about a bleep test is to find that inner doggedness, to not want to give up.
To keep going yourself. And if you drop out, encourage the person who has stayed on.
There's two lines. You just run from one to the other, but you have to get to the line before it bleeps. And then you have to get back before it bleeps again, but then the bleeps get faster and faster, so you have to get faster and faster. It's hard work.
We smoke, so we were out first.
So you don't encourage your teammates?
What was very instructive is when a couple of girls finished quite early, they actually quit the whole process entirely and they just went off to the corner of the room and I went over to say, come on, what about your team? And they reacted very negatively. In other words, they don't yet get it.
That's it, Bianca, keep going.
When people give up, it's not your body giving up, it's your head telling you. I don't know, just don't listen to your head, just keep telling yourself, keep going.
I don't know whether I'm feeling it, just gave it my all and just stayed in it as long as I could. Some people don't give it their all and some people do give it their all. People that do it are the people that succeed more, but people that don't do it, not going to get anything out of it.
So yeah, I just kept telling myself, you know, try harder. Then towards the end I couldn't go no more.
Off the chairs, get up, let's go.
Keep going.
This is tough, this is very hard to do.
Keep going. Come on, boys.
Good, and you're going again.
It's very hard.
But how do you feel you did though?
I'm wrecked.
Okay, you're out, you're done, well on.
You don't quit now, Keith, don't quit.
Stop. Oh, please, we break.
Keep going, there's no quitting. Well done.
Bianca could absolutely have given up several stages earlier, but that kind of grit and determination and self-motivation and that intrinsic want to actually know I'm going to do my best, that's That's team there. That's what that's all about.
We really need to encourage you guys to come together as a group, to come together as a team. Why? Because it's much more enjoyable. We win together, we lose together, but if we split up, we've got no chance.
So I think what we need to focus in on is the team. Why are we doing this, lads, you know? But I think they're miles off even understanding that.
Yeah, they don't get those concepts of team yet, you know?
Morning to you too, Annette.
Back at the classroom, tutors Mary Dunn and Eileen Norris have taken charge of the Munster Rugby Hero Challenge.
What you have to do, first of all, is to research this person. Research isn't just about writing one or two things, OK? We have a lot of questions and we want to get some good facts about each person, OK?
So excited!
Now, OK, are we all reasonably happy, so? Yeah. Reasonably happy and reasonably enthusiastic about doing this, are we?
Yeah. It was met with just sort of casual, sort of, maybe, don't know. Really very apathetic towards the whole thing.
Listen up. Lads, you need to listen, OK?
Negative experiences of education, combined with a lack of belief in their own abilities, leaves the trainees finding little relevance in the literacy project. Getting the group to really engage is a major challenge.
I don't like writing and having to think of... I don't know, I just don't like it. Because I just don't have the brain.
The creative writing in it will be difficult, even in school when we got tasks like that, like I didn't like doing them, so...
That should give you some information. Back to that now.
You need to know your stuff, like if you're going to interview someone, you need to know what questions to ask and...
Yeah, you need to know if they're telling you lies, or you need to know if they're trying to catch you. So...
What do you think the hardest thing of this little challenge might be, Dylan?
Wanting to do it.
Hmm?
Wanting to do it.
What really?
You don't want to do it. I don't want to do this thing. Glorial challenges.
The unfortunate thing is that you see somebody with great potential, great capacity, and not falling through in it and not using it. That's upsetting.
For now, we're going to work on preparing to make the telephone call, all right?
How to make, you know, a formal telephone call. So it's not a call.
A lot of people that we would work with, a lot of young people we would work with in this circumstance, we often talk about the negative experiences that they've had first, because that's primarily what they've met. For some people, there's a real fear around that, you know, kind of almost a fear to succeed.
You need to be able to get the information and give information, OK? So it's very important that you do it in the right way.
And I suppose what the programme is trying to do is challenge that. You know, challenge it in small ways. Have small wins and, you know, have opportunities for people to see success in action and challenge their thinking and, you know, challenge the apathy that sometimes they can present.
What am I meant to see it?
You just... It what? Yes.
Do we really have to do this? Yeah. Hello?
Hi, my name is Bianca. I'm calling because it's now a good time to talk.
Yeah. Who is John Hayes, right? You're ringing up John Hayes and you're asking him if he will meet you for an interview. You arrange a time, a date, a place.
Okay, now I want you to practice again, but this time you are available to talk, okay? God. Yes, you are available
to
talk.
Going to be available you're to gonna any of
I think the course comes in around, you know, re-engaging them and give them that kind of positivity that yes, you know, there's light at the end of the tunnel if they're feeling apathetic or, as you said, if they've come from a house where maybe people weren't working because, you know, there's no jobs there and they're feeling, you know, what's the point?
This is my old school anyway, this is my secondary school. It's been 4 years now, 3 years since I've been out of it.
I left school, I came out with a junior cert that was extremely good, but never had the ambition to go further in it.
There's no challenge in it. I found no excitement. I know there's not supposed to be excitement, but it was boring. Without a challenge, day in, day out, same thing. I'd consider myself clever enough, but school doesn't work for everyone, and it certainly didn't work for me. I hated the classroom environment, and no, it just didn't work for me whatsoever. I'm kind of still even looking at it, I still hate it. I got nothing positive out of it, and that is the honest God truth, I got nothing positive out of it, bar friends. There's one of my old buddies, strangely coming out of there. I'll see you later on. Niall, one of my best friends. and that is he's in doing grinds at the moment.
What's he studying?
Law and accounting. School-wise, he done a transition year, and I went into fifth and left halfway through fifth. Looking back in it, I see where they're going now. See where they're going now is way better, like, but I made my choices. Especially now that I'm getting older, I'm looking, I can see other doors, other windows to get back in and do things, like. But yeah, if I had a second chance round, I would have stuck it out and just done it. And God knows where I'd be.
All these photographs, I suppose you're noticing, you know.
The aim of the Munster Rugby Hero Challenge is to encourage pride in the community and test the trainees in new and interesting ways, opening minds to future possibilities.
Now, when you're photographing these rugby players, they're kind of guys with big, you know, strong features and all that. So a bit of strong light would look kind of interesting on them. So that's the basic what we're going to try to do with all these photographs. We're going to try to use just a window.
Well, that's why I want to demystify the technique and also just to you know, teach them that show them that it can be done simply.
You can see, if you look at Audrey's eyes, you can see, look, you can see the reflection of the light. Now, that's because the room is dark, but the window is bright. Couldn't be a worse day for taking a photograph, but it's looking all right, you know? So, there she is, okay. Now,
only use the window light, close in on the subject, make it as dramatic as possible.
If you put this black against me here, you see the shadows are all dark, right? Now you turn it around, use the white, and then all the shadows are brighter. So that's what that's for. And this is exactly what they do on fashion shoots, on Hollywood films, everything.
Did you see a car free pass?
Hopefully. The penny will drop. I'm only here like as this, like stabilizer on a bike. They'll be cycling the bike. Now, how's that?
I want to try and get out. You're hiding just there behind her.
Excuse me.
No.
Okay, that's good. You did great. Audrey, you might have a career here, Audrey.
Oh, yeah.
They're all very nice. Let's have a look. There's two things. See the big black thing coming out of my ear?
Yeah.
That's the background. So move so that's not in the shot. Everybody seemed to give it a lash, and I'm looking forward to how they get on in the field, so to speak.
First time ever doing something like this. So, hi, my name is Craig, and I'm from Southside Clasp. Can I arrange a meeting with you for the photographic exhibition?
The time for rehearsal is over. The next step is to book the Munster Rugby Hero for their interview and photograph. This morning, Craig will call Tony Ward, while Bianca will phone Marcus Horan.
So I'm just going to ring him and ask him. Nervous. I'd probably start stuttering on the phone.
Now the butterflies kick in.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi, is this Marcus?
Yes, Marcus,
here. Hi, Marcus. My name is Bianca Hickey.
Can I arrange, like, an interview with you in the Maldron at the 8th of February?
I would love to do that, Craig. Absolutely. Delighted to.
No.
And I'm just wondering, would you be able to accommodate me if I could meet you and interview you and take your photograph so I could use you for the exhibition?
Yeah, I'd be delighted to be in. That'd be lovely.
Thanks very much.
I'll be interviewing you with the pictures. It's for a photo gallery or a photographic exhibition.
Fantastic.
Thanks, Tony.
My pleasure, Craig, and I'm looking forward to it very much.
Enjoy your day. Bye.
You too.
Bye.
All right, thanks very much, Marcus.
Thanks.
Bye. Bye-bye. Was I good?
Bit nervous, I thought.
Yeah, I thought it was myself. My stomach, the minute I entered the phone, my stomach went upside down.
My hands are shaking. Yeah, it was grand. Thank God I had the notes ready. No, I never thought I'd be doing this a few weeks ago.
The idea of doing this in the photos, no one was pushing it at the start. But no, I actually am looking forward to it. Oh.
There's a change in personnel for today's training. Munster Rugby have sent current stars hooker Mike Sherry and second row Dave Foley to put the trainees through their paces. But the duo quickly learn that this group are tough to tame.
Four or five guys. We're going to have four or five guys in the middle, and basically what we're trying to do is... Alright lads, go on, just 2 minutes and we'll be done. Guys in the red tags are going to be in the middle and everybody else is going to be on the other side. Go!
A little bit of evasion and ball work, you know, and just basically preparing them for their trip to London. The rugby's obviously huge in Limerick. I was lucky enough to grow up a few minutes down the road from Thomond Park. Well, school's not for everyone. I messed and I danced a bit, but, you know, rugby gave me great direction and, you know, it gave me something to focus on and it brought on other aspects of my life.
It's just a bit of a reaction drill as well. So, no, she's going to have her eyes open. You're going to have your eyes closed. So when you close your eyes and she throws the ball to you, she's going to call your name and then you open your eyes and catch it.
Getting the team together and play this tournament and hopefully get somewhere in it. It should be a great boost to life, not just for me, but for the rest in the group.
Yeah, just best of luck over in London, lads. When there's more E, work as a team and you'll more than likely get the tags. So best of luck and enjoy the few weeks you have.
Thanks.
Well, thanks. Thanks.
Thomond Park sits in the heart of Ballinanty, one of Limerick's most deprived areas. Growing up in its shadow, 22-year-old Anthony Ryan was filled with the dreams and possibilities associated with sport.
Looking forward to it. The girlfriend. That's the daughter. That's the daughter then. Ballinanty, like, it's not really known as a good place for people, but there is an awful good in the community. So I've been born and reared in Ballinanty and I won't move from no one. Like, just living right next door to Tom Park, and it's just a great inspiration. And I live for the sport.
Tell the truth, I was hoping to be a professional footballer or a rugby player. Plenty of people have told me that I was good enough to be in a professional career. Like, I was just turning 18. Like, at that stage, I had trials for Limerick FC. I was kind of hoping to have that jersey on, like, and making something with life, probably having the international jersey on someday, make my family proud and things like that. And when I broke the toes and on my foot, that's when I realised that the days of football and rugby for me are over, like. There's things I can do in my life still. That's why I'm in this course now, to get that chance again and teach sports instead of being involved in them. So anything that I can pass it on to the kids.
Say hi. Say hi, yeah. You're acting shy. You're acting shy. We kiss.
For Anthony, the Rugby Hero Challenge has brought a special meeting and a dream come true.
Anthony, how you doing? Not too bad.
Great pleasure.
Nice to meet you.
I wouldn't have believed that I would have beaten John Hayes this time last month. I would have laughed if she'd taught me that, but...
How did you manage to get the name The Bull?
I suppose it's coming from a farming background. Players just stuck it on me like that, you know, so they could have called me a lot worse. So
it's incredible, I'm speechless kind of after meeting such an idol and a hero. It was an inspiration.
I do see you as a Munster hero. Like, it was always an inspiration looking up at yourself and like the likes of Paul coming into Din.
Yeah. Like, it's not something maybe you set out to do, like, but when people name you as, you know, someone that they looked up to or whatever like that, it does give you a good feeling, like, you know, that something you did maybe had an effect on somebody.
After weeks of preparation, the moment of truth has arrived for the rest of the trainees too.
I always imagine a rugby player as big and strong and kind of angry, you know, when you look at him on telly. But when he came in then, he was really friendly and really outgoing. You know, he was like a different person. So it was 14 years you were playing with Munster?
Yeah, 14 years as a professional rugby player, and he
you know, a lot of highs, and made a lot of friends along the way as well. So it's been, it's a part of my life that I'm very proud of. And, yeah. You know, I'm just dealing with retirement now, and that's kind of tough.
Is that right if we take our photo?
Yeah.
Is that
yeah.
okay?
For Audrey and Keith, it's time to put their training into practice as they shoot Grand Slam winner Niamh Briggs.
Yeah, I can see the difference with the light and the shadows. This is my favourite one.
There we go. Very nice.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Airbrush out the wrinkles, you're...
You've no wrinkles, you're lovely. I think it's lovely, I'm really happy with it. And I think it came out well for my first photo. I'm really proud of it.
So I was nervous at the start for the first couple of pictures, my hands were shaking. But yeah, when I got into Denny, I was grand, and the photos kind of started coming out better as well.
So, if rugby paid your bills, would you still be a guard?
We told you I was a guard.
We googled you yesterday. It's all week googling you.
I wanted to be a guard since I was really, really young. It was the profession that I wanted to be in. So to be, you know, to be able to combine two things that I absolutely love is just, you know, it's almost like not really making a living, and it's kind of like I really enjoy it. So.
You can't really tell a person by googling them, can you?
No.
Until they come and meet them face to face. It's hard. When you're out, it's just out of your comfort zone, like.
James and Dylan's hero is Brendan Foley, Munster legend, and Rosie's dad.
Obviously the 1978 match. What was the feeling like in the dressing room before it?
There was always a feeling that one day that somebody was going to beat him, and you were hoping that, because you know,
it's your daughter's, and you must be very proud of her, what she's done.
Rosie used to come along to the coaching sessions or training sessions after school, you know, and I thought she was just a normal, healthy girl that she was spotting the boys, but she told me afterwards that she'd have loved to be out there playing, you know.
What was your best moment in your career?
Definitely winning the Grand Slam last year was just an unbelievable, you know, it was just, I can't even really put it into words to describe the feelings once that final whistle went.
The most memorable one for me was winning the Grand Slam with Ireland. It was a great occasion for the whole country and for rugby in Ireland, but for me growing up it was something that I always dreamed of doing and being involved in with an Irish team, and to finally do it. It was just a great day, a great occasion, and I definitely haven't surpassed that in anything else in my career, you know.
What's your line for the future now that you're in retirement? What's your line for the future?
Farming always is what keeps me busy at the moment, and I miss the teammates and stuff, you know, and playing in Thomond Park, and you miss the crack in the dressing room after the game. That's special when you get a win, and it's just great banter and slagging each other. It's a great crack, and that's what you miss most. Like you kind of have to grow up a small bit once you leave. Like
it's,
you can't
the
be
friendship you miss.
Yeah, you can't be acting like a big schoolboy anymore. So
I think now that I've done it, I think if I had to do it again in the near future, I'd be calmer about it, and hopefully sometime in the future I will get to do it again.
The very fact now that we're going out to the London Wasps, what advice would you give for somebody starting out in rugby like myself?
As I said, the main thing is to enjoy it, you know, try and hone in on the skills.
Be thinking about the game all the time, get your training done, fitness training done. The fitter you are, the easier it'll be to play. It's just to prepare well. You can't just turn up on the day and hope that everything's going to happen. It doesn't work out that way.
You've got to travel over as a team and play as a team, and that's hugely important. I think it was hugely important for us as a Munster team when we played away from home. It's all about bonding together as a group, I think, as well, you know.
Yeah, thanks very much for your time, Marcus.
Thanks, Bianca. Nice talking to you.
So, yeah, I think it's going to be easy to do the exhibition because he gave me so much information. I'm definitely going to be able to write 200 words about him. Yeah, like, I didn't think I would be able to sit down and interview a Munster hero and take his picture and everything. I never imagined that I'd be able to do that.
If you think you need to have played rugby before to play tag, think again.
With 7 weeks to go to the London tournament, today it's time for tactics as the coaches try to hammer home the laws of tag rugby.
Each team consists of seven players, four guys and three girls, with a strict no-contact policy.
So the defender here just puts his arm out and blocks the runner. Again, that's contact and that would be a penalty.
Successful tag teams are ones that defend as a team, attack as a team and pass as a team, with the girls playing a key role. Why? Because a guy try will get you just 1 point. but a girl try will give you 3.
I think all the rules that we were giving them, it becomes a bit daunting for them.
OK, just to get you warmed up and to get used to it, we play our end ball games.
That's it. No, Craig, don't just stand there as if something special is going to happen to you. Yeah, but go and move and work for it, OK?
Move like a dancer, girl. Good pass. Yes.
Well done.
Much
well done.
Better.
Don't go as far away,
run
Craig.
Run through there, run
Craig,
through there.
Give her a chance. She's only learning it, so don't go as far away, and she's getting better. Well done.
I love it. I actually love it. And we'll put our 110% into it, but we have to get a lot more training in.
Look at the feet. Fantastic, quick feet.
You were opposite. No, face them! Face them! Face them! Good
time! Bleep test scores from a while back, you're kind of conscious. And all of a sudden, the person who performed poorest in the bleep test quits. And those who are going to have a heart attack.
No heart attacks allowed.
You know what? I might go get a drink. We're almost finished. Woo! Give me a couple of minutes. We're almost finished. All right, lads.
It's a pity that not all of them will take on the challenge, which is the aspect I'd find most disappointing, I'd say.
One of the spaces. One of the spaces. Good, go, go, go,
Craig is like an electric eel. Where's the action? Keep the action. And he was getting loads of tags. He was brilliant. Yeah.
Move, move, move. Ah, mind the feet.
People are putting, they're starting to put effort into it now because we don't want to go over there and just lose. Do you get me? Yeah.
By the way, there's 2 girls playing in your team. They're tried. They get 3 points. They get 3 points for a try.
That's
the time.
I thought they improved as the session went on. Yeah. We tried to introduce that the girls are worth 3 and the boys are only worth 1 try and that. Yeah. So, I mean, we can really kind of develop that more, I think, next week.
Lining up, it's not a hard game. It really is not a hard game, all right? It's not.
But it was good fun there. It's good fun. Great play. By the way, the best tagger of the session, Craig, without a shadow of a doubt.
I don't know.
So getting out on the pitches, there were a few said it to me there, you know, let's go on the pitches.
Let's go on the pitches, right? Yeah.
Exhausting, no, to be honest. Good game, though. I'm ready for him, I'm ready. I'll have my fighting Irish.
It's the morning of the Munster Rugby Hero Exhibition, and there's a lot of work to be done if the venue is to be ready for tonight's launch.
So if I can help with anything, let me know, but you decide what way you want your exhibition to look. Good, isn't it? I look forward to tonight. It's very exciting.
But of the 14 trainees on the course, only 8 have turned up to prepare the space. There are notable absentees, including James, who is due to give tonight's welcoming address.
James?
Yes.
It's Bianca. Are you coming down to the printmakers?
Yeah, I'll be down there. What time is it down there?
We're down here now, waiting for you.
Oh, yeah, I'll be down now for the next half an hour.
I'll have the dentist. All right, so bye. Bye. Just have to dentist. I'll be here in a half an hour.
It's an arts programme as well as sports programme, so we've done this the last few weeks, so we just thought if we're having an exhibition, we might as well just show our pieces of art as well.
Teamwork is that's looking good at the moment. Bianca and Audrey are, they seem to be calling the shots all right. They're organising people quite well.
Which one is yours?
So is everyone's coming from the group? Where's Rebecca? Oh no, Craig is absent. And Anthony is absent. And I don't know if they're coming or not. Yeah, of course they're missing out. They're leaving us down. They're leaving their class down.
James and Dylan eventually arrive. Late, and without their piece on rugby hero, Brendan Foley.
We're writing up a paragraph on Brendan Foley again because Dylan here forgot his. But sure, you can do it again.
He played his heart out and against all odds, they triumphed over the Kiwi side. Not only is Brendan Knight kind of sport, he is a true gentleman.
I'm more visual, he's more intellectual, let's put it that way. He'd be more the brains, I'd be more the artistic sort of person, you know? Yeah. That's excellent. Really like that. It's better than what I thought it would be. A lot better. It should be fun, and I think my mother is going to be more than proud of me later on as well, to see that that I'm actually doing something with my life as opposed to 2 years ago I was doing nothing.
Just trying to figure out which switch is the right side.
It's like extreme makeover in the final 7 minutes.
James, what when you're going to do your speech? When everyone arrives or everyone says cheers?
I think we worked very well as a team. Yeah, I think we all got, well, obviously the people that didn't turn up didn't, but whoever was there, we all kind of made an effort, you know?
Stand back to clean up at the end, begging at me.
By 6 o'clock, the room is ready. This assignment dropped the trainees into unfamiliar territory, but tonight is an opportunity for the group, including some of the junior members, to celebrate their achievement.
It looks great. It looks very professional and everything. It really looks the part.
Is there more people coming?
Hi, James. You're looking well.
Oh, you're lovely.
Where's everyone else? Yeah. Oh. I thought there'd be loads here. I was trying to be fashionably late.
After all the hard work that went into completing this task, only 6 of the 14 trainees have turned up for the exhibition. For some, the morning's optimism has given way to apathy. It's clear that the biggest challenge facing this group is commitment.
Well, like, you don't know what's going on in people's lives. I don't know why people are absent, you know. I suppose everyone just has their own things, other commitments or problems. And some people have poor attendance, but I suppose that's just them. Do you know?
Right, so first I'd like to welcome everyone here. I hope you've enjoyed the display. I, on behalf of the course, would like to thank all the sporting legends for kindly giving up their spare time to do interviews with us all. And I'd also like to thank Rosie and Liam for all the training that you've given us. And I hope you all enjoy the display.
Are these your works as well?
Neil Briggs over here is my one, myself and Keith. Keith isn't here yet. We interviewed Neil. We researched her and then we asked her a couple of questions, things that we couldn't really get online, just her opinion. So.
Oh, yeah. And then, so how did the whole thing work out for you? Like, was it enjoyable? Was it tough?
It was enjoyable. It was just a new experience, really. Everything was just new. So yeah. It's just, I liked it. Yeah, it was a good experience. Yeah.
Is it your best work?
I think that's a key part of the programme, is reconnecting people with the skills of, you know, the basic skills that we all have around our communication skills and our reading, writing skills and so on. So, you know, having those strong skills are a real key to accessing, you know, opportunity in life. So it's great to see that they're connecting, you know, the fun stuff like the photography with those core skills as well.
I'm checking your spelling.
I don't find any spelling errors there.
It's been very interesting. It's been a learning curve for the lads, but for us as well. It really has. And I suppose there's been positives and negatives, but more positives, absolutely.
Look at this. It's amazing. Better than sitting at home doing
nothing anyway. For me, it's fantastic. When I look at something like that and realise that my own son done that, that's absolutely fantastic. I'm really, really proud of him. He's very much always has been a very strong individual, very intelligent young fella as well, not because he's my son, but didn't use it in the way he should have used it, you know?
You know, it's a big world out there. They can bring a lot to it. They've learned how to use their skills now in new ways. And, it's all about opportunity. So hopefully they'll take the next opportunity that comes away and a little bit more confidence about that as well.
The reward is here. The journey they're on has been successful for most of them. But looking around, it's the same faces that are here who impressed me on the pitch are here doing a lot of the work.
I'm proud of us as a group. Like, the night still went off all right. It wasn't that we couldn't go ahead with the night because certain people didn't turn up. We'd done it without them anyway. The turnout wasn't great. I know there could have been more of a crowd there and there wasn't, but shit happens.
Next week, the trainees are given a VIP experience at Thomond Park, which brings a new writing challenge.
We're asking you just to do a 250-word on your experience here in Thomond Park.
And with the clock ticking on the London Tag competition, apathy and a lack of commitment continue to dog training.
I don't mind you being terrible and learning, but if you just don't give a shit, I'm just going to go away. I have better things to do with my life.
Can the group forge a team spirit in time?